All right, good morning everyone. I hope all of you are safe and having a great time at your home. Today I have all the intentions to finish this chapter during the stay activities. This is our complete unit. I believe we'll be able to cover it up. So before I actually start with today's topic, let us see what we have covered so far in this particular topic. So let me go back to my previous slides. So during the stay activities, under this, what we have, when it is done and who does it, right? We have discussed this. Then in the previous class, we were discussing about mail handling. What are the different types of mails, incoming and outgoing, and what is the procedure of dealing with the mails? This we have already discussed in the previous session. Then moving forward, we also saw these formats of incoming mail logbook and the use of mail forwarding address slip. We also discussed about outgoing mail and what is the use of this miscellaneous charge voucher that is prepared by the cashier. We have discussed this. Message handling was another topic. After mail handling, we also discussed about message handling in the previous session, where we discuss what is a message, who leaves message for whom, and the format of message slip, how to fill it up, and what is how many copies are made, and what is the use of this slip. After that, we discussed about the location or the paging of a guest paging, and we discussed that there are three ways to page a guest, and then there's another way using technology. So how can a guest be located in the hotel when he has requested? Change of guest room was also a topic that we discussed in the last class, where we discussed that there are certain conditions on the basis of which a change of guest room may be done even while the guest is staying in the hotel. So what are the possible reasons for change of guest room? Why would a guest want to change his room, or why would a hotel want to change the room of the guest? All right, so we already discussed this, and if you remember, we discussed the live move and the dead move in the last session. So what is the meaning of the live move and the dead move? We also saw this format of room change slip, wherein we discussed that the departments, to all the departments to which it goes. So who prepares it, and what is the purpose of preparing this, and it is sent to whom? So all these things were being discussed. Today we'll be discussing about safe deposit locker, and then we'll be discussing, this we have already discussed, room, if you can see, room key control. Room key control, if you remember, we discussed in the first online class the different types of keys that's being used, what happens if a hotel uses a traditional key. And what is the difference between key card and card key, and the different types of card keys these days being used by the hotel after COVID-19, how the scenario is going to change, how this use of keys is going to be replaced with the use of mobile phones to open the guest room doors. This is what we have discussed in the first class or first online class. We also discussed the importance and the procedure of key control. As we discussed that earlier, there used to be traditional keys. So there were chances of it being, of it getting lost. So we also discussed that, you know, the format of key control sheet, which is being prepared for the control of the keys. Key card we have discussed. Left luggage handling is a topic that we are going to cover up today. The safe deposit locker we are going to discuss today. Left luggage handling we are going to discuss today. We are also going to discuss about wake up call. What is it? Why is it given? And what is this wake up call register? And we are also going to discuss very briefly about guest complaints. As you know that I have already put a video on YouTube before our vacations about this particular topic, guest complaints. You must have seen this, but in case if you forgot or you have not seen this, then we'll have a quick recap of dealing with guest complaints. And finally, to finish off with this topic, we have this very important topic, that is maintaining guest folios. So if you remember, this is one topic that we have taken in detail, in depth, in the second or the third online session, wherein we discuss what is a folio, what is a guest folio, what is a non-guest folio, what are the different types of folios being prepared. Non-guest folio includes skipper's accounts, no-show, retention charges. This is all we discussed in one complete session. Then what is city ledger? Everything has been discussed so far in detail. Though it is not given in notes in that much detail because it is basically a topic of second year. So in second year, your focus will be on folios. So, but I believe that I've covered it up so that when you move to your second year, you'll have a lot of inputs. You already have a lot of inputs and it is going to help you in your second year to understand this topic better because it's a very important topic. So we will be coming back now. We will be coming back to a presentation and we will then start with our today's topic. And in between, if you have any doubts, we will adopt the same procedure as we do of WhatsApp messaging. So in case if there is any doubt anywhere, you may please WhatsApp and we can take those doubts. In case you have any doubts in the previous topics that we have covered in this particular chapter, we can even deal with that. And today we are going to finish it off. But before that, let's do the attendance. All right. So I request everyone to switch on their camera so that attendance can be done. Adarsh, Mohit, Tushar, Rohit. Yathad, sit straight. Your face is not visible. Stuti, Nikhil, Kumar, you are not visible. Nikhil, Kumar, Charushi, Amit, Rohit Yadav, Vikas Gangwar, Ashwini Pal, Nandini Agarwal, Dhruv, Anushka Vikram, Aklak, Naman Adlaka, Ashwini. All right, so attendance is done. Okay, so attendance is done. Now let's come back to our today's topic. Okay, so we'll move back to our scope slide so to see what's been done. We have discussed about mail handling, message handling. We have discussed mail handling, message handling, paging or locating of a guest, change of guest room. This is what we have discussed. We'll start our discussion with safe deposit locker. Left luggage facility, wake up call and dealing with guest complaints. And I'm sure you have done most of the things in the first semester in the form of role plays. So you already have a brief idea, but just to do a quick recap so that if there is any doubts left, we can discuss it. All right, so we'll start with our today's topic, that is safe deposit locker. And in this photograph, you can see that there's a safe deposit locker. All right, it is also called as safety deposit or safety deposit locker. So, or it may be also called as electronic locker. There are various names to it, but the purpose is the same. The purpose is to keep the guest valuables in it. So basically, this is not meant for employees. Please make sure that employees are not given this facility of using the safe deposit locker. It is only meant for residential guests. So in this safe deposit locker, you can see that there are numbers there and it is a screen also, a small screen also there in the picture. So basically, the guest who wants to keep anything in his valuables, he can keep it in this locker. This locker is usually open when the guest checks in. All right, so housekeeping ensures while cleaning the room, the vacant room before the guest arrival, the housekeeping department ensures that this locker remains open. It should not be closed. All right, and the guest, when he checks in and he wants to keep anything valuable in it, he can keep it since the locker is open, and he will close the door and give any four digits of his choice. For example, he presses 1111 four times, right? So that becomes a code. Now this code has to be used even for opening this locker. So when the guest wants to take out something from this locker, he will again press 1, 1, 1 and 1, 4 times. So the locker would remain open. A locker would get open and he will take out his valuables. So this is the procedure of operating the safety deposit locker. So it is to be ensured that when the guest checks, when the guest is checking out, the housekeeping department ensures that the locker is not closed. Supposingly the guest is checking out and the receptionist or the cashier is calling up. Usually when a checkout takes place, the receptionist or the cashier calls up the housekeeping and informs that this particular room is checking out. Please go and check the room. So the housekeeping person goes and he inspects. Housekeeping person means either the floor supervisor or the room attendant, GRA, guest room attendant. He would go and he would inspect the room. Is anything broken? Is anything damaged? Is anything stolen? All right, there are chances. There are times, you know, when the GRA went inside the room at the time of checkout and he found that the lamp is broken completely. The lampshade is broken. The lamp is on the floor, or there is a huge damage on the carpet of the floor. So all these things, anything missing, anything damaged, has to be reported back. Even the consumption of minibar items, because if the guest has consumed something before his checkout, then it is not added in the final bill. So whatever consumption in the minibar consumption is there in the room, that is to be added to the final bill, and that is to be reported by the GRA or the floor supervisor. They have to give a call immediately and tell that there is a consumption of 2 chocolates and 2 soft drinks. Alright? And then he would also check whether the safety deposit locker is open or not. So if it is closed, then we can immediately inform the guest that, sir, were you using your safety deposit locker? He would say, yes, I was using it. I've kept, oh, sorry, I forgot. My valuables are still inside. So that is a reminder for him. He can go back and he can pick out his valuables. All right. So this is also to be ensured at the time of checkout by the housekeeping department. All right. So safe deposit locker is not just available in the guest room. It is also available behind the cashier, behind the front desk. Back office, I'm sure you remember we discussed about back office. So somewhere in the back office, behind the cashier or in a separate enclosed area, there would be some safe deposit locker facility available for the guest. You know what happens at times? The guest feels that anybody can come in my room. GRAs are coming for cleaning of rooms, or the gardener is coming. In case there is some plant kept in the balcony, then the gardener would be coming to water the plant. The maintenance guy would be coming for some repair. So at times, you know, the guests are very skeptical. They might feel that anybody would come in my room and, you know, things are not safe in my room. So in that case, he might request for a safe deposit locker facility available at the reception, because he believes that anything kept at the reception would be safer than keeping things in his safety deposit locker in his room. All right. Where is the safety deposit locker in the room? In the wardrobe. So there are 2 wardrobes in each room. So in one of the wardrobe, there will be 1 safe deposit locker fixed in the wardrobe. That is fixed, right? It is not movable. So either the guest can use the safe deposit locker in his own room, or if he wishes, he can use the one that is behind the cashier, taken care by the cashier, or if he has more valuables. For example, somebody is coming for a wedding. So you might be carrying, he or she might be carrying a lot of jewelry and cash and other stuff. So in that case, they may request to use both the safe deposit lockers. All right. One thing that needs mentioning here is that it is usually not chargeable. Most of the hotels doesn't charge for this facility. All right. So this is a complimentary facility usually given by the hotels to its guests. All right. The procedure of safe deposit locker remains the same as we have in banks, which means that there will be 2 keys to the safe deposit locker. Here it is in the room. The one that you see in the picture, it is kept in the room. So it has this electronic thing. You put a code and that becomes the, you put any 4 digits and that becomes the code. Whereas in case of the safety deposit locker at the cashier, behind the cashier's desk, what would happen? That would be basically the same as bank lockers. So there will be two keys to it. One will be with the cashier and the other key will be given to the guest. All right, so to open the locker, both the keys need to be inserted at the same time. But to close the locker, only one key is more than sufficient. All right, so I hope you have been to banks at times with your parents. So you must have seen how the safe deposit locker works. All right, so basically there is a safety deposit locker register also that's being maintained. So in this register, in this format, you can see that it will have all the details of the guest who's using this locker facility at the back office. All right, so it is obviously it will have the date and the name of the guest and room number. And one additional thing is locker number. So every locker will have a number. So it is to be written which locker number is to be issued to whom. All right, key issued every time when the guest wants to have access to the locker, there has to be an entry made in this register. So key issued, guest signature, time in and time out. So this is the format of safe deposit locker. Any questions till now? You may please WhatsApp me. All right, so no questions as of now. I've not received any questions in my WhatsApp. So I believe that there is no confusion till now. Safe deposit locker is clear. Ariman, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So I hope it is clear to others also. If you have any doubts, please WhatsApp me. All right, moving further. Now we talk about left luggage handling. This is something that you have practically done in your first semester role plays. You have even got evaluated on the basis of your role plays. So this is again a recap. Left luggage, what is left luggage? Ariman, do you have any idea?
Ma'am, the voice.
Left luggage, what is left luggage? No idea? All right, no problem. I'll explain it to you. Left luggage, anyone, any idea, you can WhatsApp me if you know what is left luggage. I'll wait for 1 minute for your answer in WhatsApp group. What is a left luggage? All right, I see people typing it. Very good. I'm very happy. So many of them typing. Very good. Just give me the keywords. Don't write the entire definition. Only the keywords. Harnoor is typing. Down bell activity. Okay, all right. That is true. That is taken. It is done at the time of down bell. Very good. When the guest wants to keep any luggage in the hotel itself, because they will be back in the same hotel. Very good. I've got the answer. So many of you are writing. Thank you very much, beta. I'm really very happy. Thank you. Okay, Biswajit ka answer tha wo, down bell activity. Okay, all right, stop writing. I am very happy that most of you know the answer. Aapko bahut aata hai, very good. That's like my students. Sab kuch aata hai mere students ko. Okay, so very good. I've got all the correct answers. Sabhi ne sare correct answers diye. Preeti ne bhi diya hai. Bakyo ne bhi diya hai. Very good, Harnoor ne bhi diya hai. All right. So jinne nahi yaad hai, unhe bata dete hai. Left luggage means at the time of down bell activity. Now, what is down bell activity? Down bell activity is luggage handling at the time of checkout. So, when the guest is checking out, down bell activity takes place, means the luggage is taken from the room to the lobby and then to the coach or the car of the guest. All right, so during this down bell activity, when the guest is checking out, the checking out guest may request the cashier or anybody at the front desk that I would like to keep my bags with the hotel since I will come back after some days. So I'm keeping some of my belongings here with the hotel and I will collect it back. When I come back to the hotel after 15 days, I have another reservation. So I will collect my bags. Or at times the guest is going to some other place and he would be coming back. So he says that I don't want to carry all these bags with me. So could you please keep one bag or two bags of mine with you, which I will collect back later, after 5 days or 10 days or whatever the time. All right, so very good. I'm really happy. A lot of answers I have received from a lot of students. Am I visible and am I audible? Ariman, where are you?
Visible,
yes, ma'am.
All right. Sorry, there was a problem with my electricity. There's no electricity now, so I had login from my mobile data. All right. So I hope there will be no further problems now. So coming back to my presentation. All right, so we're talking about left luggage, and left luggage, Ayan Mirza says that it refers to the luggage left by a guest who checks out of the hotel but wishes to take his luggage later. So very well said. Very good, all of you. Everybody has given the right answers. So yes, left luggage, the guest wishes to keep his luggage, so he's expressing that he would like to keep his 2 bags or 3 bags or 1 bag with the hotel. So there is a left luggage room. Now this left luggage room is behind the bell desk. Wherever there is a bell desk, there would be a left luggage room. When the guest makes a request, please remember that all these facilities are available only on request. All right, so when the guest requests for this facility, then that luggage is to be taken care by the bell desk now. So basically the bell boy and a bell captain will come, and we don't want our guest to move from desk to desk. Supposingly, if he's telling this to the cashier, and the cashier will not say that, sir, you please go to bell desk, we will help you. No, it is the staff who should be roaming around the guest. It should not be the guest who should be going from desk to desk. So when the staff, when the guest requests, the bellboy and the bell captain would come with the left luggage register. All right, and in that left luggage register, there will be again columns made. I'll show you the format of left luggage register. It has given me your notes. So basically, the entry is to be made in the left luggage register, and there is a luggage tag. If you see in this picture, there is a tag attached to the suitcase. So the similar kind of tag, which will have two copies. Two copies means this is a long tag. It will have perforations in between. Perforation का मतलब छेद होता है, तो उसमें बीच में छेद होंगे, वहां से वो टैग क्लियर हो जाएगा. ऑलराइट, सो वन बैगेज टैग, लेफ्ट बैगेज टैग, इट विल हैव टू पार्ट्स. वन पार्ट ऑफ द बैगेज टैग विल बी अटैच्ड टू द बैगेज, एज यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर, एंड द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द बैगेज टैग विद द सेम सीरियल नंबर विल बी हैंडेड ओवर टू द गेस्ट. तो अगर पहले पार्ट में लिखा हुआ है, बैगेज टैग के पहले पार्ट में लिखा हुआ है सीरियल नंबर 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, तो दूसरा जो टर्क किया जाएगा उससे, उस पर भी लिखा होगा 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, एंड दैट विल बी हैंडेड ओवर टू द गेस्ट. राइट, सो व्हेन द गेस्ट रिक्वेस्ट फॉर इट, ही हैज टू फिल अप अ लेफ्ट लगेज रजिस्टर विद अ सिग्नेचर. इट विल हैव द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द लगेज, गेस्ट का नाम, उसका रूम नंबर, व्हेन इज ही चेकिंग आउट, द टाइम, डेट एंड टाइम, एंड देन द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द लगेज. कैसा है, सूटकेस है तो कितने सूटकेसेस हैं, बैकपैक है तो कितना बैकपैक है. सो डिस्क्रिप्शन अबाउट द लगेज विल बी रिटन इन द रजिस्टर, एंड द गेस्ट एनी इंस्ट्रक्शंस, एंड व्हेन द गेस्ट इज गोइंग टू कलेक्ट इट बैक, दैट इज आल्सो रिटन विद द सिग्नेचर ऑफ द गेस्ट. ऑलराइट, सो व्हेन द गेस्ट हैज रिक्वेस्टेड, द फॉर्मेलिटीज आर डन, अ पार्ट ऑफ द लगेज, लेफ्ट लगेज टैग इज गिवन टू हिम, एंड then he checks out of the hotel. So now when he comes back, what happens? He has to produce his part of the luggage tag that is being tallied with the luggage tag that is attached with the bag. All right, so the bag is identified, and then the luggage register is presented to the guest so that he signs in as an acknowledgement that yes, he is collecting back his baggage, and then he can take his luggage with him. You know, at times it happens that the guest said that I'll be coming after 15 days, but it might happen that he couldn't come back due to some change in plans. So he may request somebody on his behalf to take it. Right? This may happen. So that is why, in case if the guest is requesting us that please give my baggage to Mr. So and so. In that case, the hotel would want an authorization letter from the guest saying that since I'm not able to come, please hand over my luggage to Mr. So-and-so, I will be completely responsible for any loss or damage of my baggages once you hand over it to Mr. So-and-so. All right? So without authorization letter, we will not give the luggage of the guest to anyone. If it is the guest himself, well and good. But if not the guest, then with an authorization letter, which will be kept in the file. Okay, all right. So this is done. Left luggage register, left luggage tag has been done. Now coming to the wake up call. Wake up call. Why do you now? I want you to text me. Why would anybody request for wake up call? Everybody is carrying mobile phones with him or her. So why would anybody request for a wake up call? Text me the answer. Okay, till you are typing it, I have got one question which I'm going to address it right now. All right, Adarsh Gupta has asked one question. Ma'am, left luggage room is also called as cloak room. So yes, cloak room is basically a term used for keeping the left luggage at the railway stations and bus stands. Aap ISBT Shimla par jaoge na, wahan jo new ISBT hai, wahan pe cloak rooms hai. Jo unhe cloak room bolte hai, but that is basically left luggage rooms. So haan, kai jagah pe hum hotel mein cloak room nahi bolte hai, hotel mein bolte hai left luggage room. But haan, railway stations pe wahan pe bolte hai, isko cloak room. All right, so two questions I have. First question is, what will happen when the guest lost his or her luggage tag? All right, so what will happen if a guest loses his luggage tag? Any answers? What will happen? Aryaman, do you have any answer? Because since you're the only one who's unmute. Any answers?
No, ma'am.
No? Aryaman? डांट लगानी पड़ेगी तुम्हें अभी मुझे चलिए सो इफ एनीवन द गेस्ट हैज लॉस्ट हिज लगेज टैग देन इन दैट केस ही हैज टू गिव प्रूफ ऑफ हिज आइडेंटिटी आइदर ही कैन शो हिज आधार कार्ड और हिज पैन कार्ड और हिज ड्राइविंग लाइसेंस और हिज पासपोर्ट बेसिकली लगेज टैग द पर्पस ऑफ द लगेज टैग इज टू मेक श्योर दैट द बैगेज इज हैंडल्ड टू द राइट पर्सन राइट इफ ही इज इवन लॉस्ट हिज लगेज टैग नो इश्यूज once we verify, once we authenticate the identity of the guest and we are sure that yes, he was the one who left his luggage, we can hand him over and we can after taking his signature, we can write the same in the remarks column that the guest has lost his luggage tag, so identified on the basis of his driving license. That is, whatever remarks is there, we can always note it down. All right, so in case if there is any later on any discrepancies as far as luggage is concerned, that can be taken care of. So I hope I've answered this question properly. There's one more question by Adarsh. Let's see. All right, I've even received an answer. He has to show proof. Very good. I'm really happy. बहुत खुशी हो रही है मुझे तुम लोग पढ़ाई लिखाई करते हो. Very good. एक और क्वेश्चन था व्हाट वाज इट आई एम नॉट एबल टू लोकेट इट नाउ
बेटा जिसने क्वेश्चन पूछना है वो हैंड रेज कर सकते हैं मैं उस इंडिविजुअल स्टूडेंट को अनम्यूट कर दूंगा
प्लीज रेज योर हैंड इफ यू हैव अ क्वेश्चन बिकॉज़ देयर इज वन क्वेश्चन दैट आई हैव मिस्ड आई एम नॉट एबल टू फिगर इट आउट नाउ Okay, here's the question. Okay, is the hotel responsible for any loss occurred to the guest luggage? All right, so if the hotel has lost the guest baggage, what do you think? Obviously, if the hotel is taking responsibility of the luggage, then obviously the hotel has to bear the loss, isn't it? Though it is a facility given, but then if let's say some damage occurs to the guest baggage due to some pest problem. ठीक है, चूहा था. Supposingly, मान लेते हैं और उसने बैग को काट दिया तो ऑब्वियसली तो होटल की गलती है सो होटल विल बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल राइट So yes, hotel will be responsible. All right. So now moving to our wake-up call. I have received so many answers. Again, the correct answers. All right. People have written that wake-up calls are requested so that guests do not miss the meeting. Yes. You know, I'm pretty sure that some of the students in your batch also would be needing some personal pat on the back to wake up for the classes. Hai na? Subah 9 baje ki class ke liye, I'm sure aise bahut honge jo taang khichne pe aur bed se dhakka maarne pe uthte honge. All right, so there are certain guests who might not completely rely on their mobile phones, alarm phones on their mobile. They would want somebody to personally wake up the guest. All right, there are certain guests who may need a bed tea immediately they get up from the bed. So they would need a bed tea or a bed coffee, and then only they'll be able to open up their eyes. So usually wake up calls, these days guest doesn't request for it because everybody is carrying mobile phones. Earlier they were not carrying it, so they were requesting it. But still these days you will find that certain guests will request for wake up call for the only reason is that they are not sure that they'll be able to wake up on time. So if they have this fear of missing the alarm, or if they have this, if they want something refreshing to wake them up, then they might request that please, I need a wake up call at 4 with a bed tea or a coffee. All right. So that is why they might still these days also they might request for a wake up call facility. All right. So very good. Everybody is given the right answers. Okay. All right. So basically wake up call, EPABX yaad hai aapko humne first semester mein kiya tha. EPABX. I need the answers for EPABX if you have. What is EPABX? Fatafat. Full form of EPABX. Nandini is typing.
जिसने आंसर करना है वो अनम्यूट कर सकता है अपने आप को.
EPABX फुल फॉर्म. श्रुति. नॉट गॉट एनी आंसर्स.
Electronic private automatic.
Private automatic branch exchange.
Okay, very good, Shruti. All right, thank you very much. Electronic private automatic branch exchange. All right, so EPABX. So every hotel will have this EPABX. We call it as telephone exchange. Like the name itself says, branch exchange, automatic, electronic automatic private branch exchange. So it itself is a exchange. Telephone exchange for the hotel. So basically, the hotel will have this facility. Every hotel is using EPABX. So basically, it will also have the facility of wake up call. So whenever the request for wake up call is received, it is entered in the wake up call register. The wake up call register is on your screen. You can see the format of wake up call register. So it is entered here as well as in the EPABX. So the EPABX automatically gives a call to the guest room. All right, and when the guest picks up the phone, there will be a pre-recorded message playing that, sir, this is a wake up call for you. Good morning, sir, this is a wake good morning, this is a wake up call for you, something like this. So basically, thank you very much. I've received so many correct answers now in my WhatsApp. Very good. All right, so wake up call facility we have discussed. We have also discussed about wake up call register. In case the guest wants a bed tea or a coffee, then it is the machine as well as the room service staff who would go with a cup of coffee or tea and serve it to the guest. All right. So depending on the request of the guest that he's made, how he would want his wake up call would to be based on his information, wake up call would be given to the guest. Now moving further, dealing with guest complaints, ये कर लिया है, इसलिए मैं not going to detail. इसका video available है YouTube पे. Still, very quickly we'll just see these four points. Firstly, what is a complaint? So complaint is an expression of dissatisfaction. All right. So if dissatisfaction is not expressed, we will not be able to consider it as a complaint. जब तक बोला ना जाए, बोलने का मतलब not essentially through words, but even through body language. So if the guest is not happy or pleased with the services, the hotel staff will be able to make out from the body language of the guest that he is not satisfied or he has some issues with us. So complaint का मतलब है जब उसको express किया जाए, ठीक है? Words में है तो बहुत ही अच्छा है क्योंकि वो clear है. लेकिन अगर body language से भी है तो जीआरई का काम है वो जाए और पूछे दैट सर इज एवरीथिंग ऑल राइट इज एनी प्रॉब्लम ऑल राइट सो दैट कंप्लेंट मतलब एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ डिससैटिस्फैक्शन रीजंस देयर वेरियस रीजंस ठीक है अब होटल में इतनी सारी चीजें हैं इतने सारे लोग हैं सो देयर आर मल्टीपल रीजंस इट इज गिवन इन योर नोट्स इट इज आल्सो कवर्ड इन डिटेल इन द वीडियो सो यू मे प्लीज वॉच दैट लेटर Types of complaints, usually the guest may say geyser is not working, I'm not able to see dashboards, or I don't like the attitude of this particular staff. Right? So they're based on the basis of different complaints, we divide into four categories, starting with mechanical or technical complaints, wherein we would say that anything related to the malfunctioning of the machineries and equipments will be a technical complaint. All right, so geyser not working, TV channel is not clear, telephone not working, mini bar not cooling. All these are mechanical or technical complaints related to machineries. All right, नल में पानी नहीं आ रहा है वो भी इसमें ही आएगा, ठीक है? Service related complaints means anything that has got to do with the service. खाना ठंडा था, taste नहीं था, I wasn't served piping hot soup. All right, or my room was not cleaned thoroughly. So these are service related complaints. Anything that is got to do with the service part. All right, where the employees are providing a service to the guest. मेरे बेड शीट चेंज नहीं हुए. These are some examples. Attitudinal means about the attitude of the staff. All right, sometimes it happens that the guest is working, he's busy in his own world, and he's paying all attention in cleaning the room, and the guest enters and he doesn't notice us. Then the guest would say, देखो मुझे विश नहीं किया मैं आया और मुझे विश भी नहीं किया आपके स्टाफ ने और मे बी अ रूड बिहेवियर दैट इज ऑल एटीट्यूडनल कंप्लेंट्स एंड फाइनली इज अनयूजुअल कंप्लेंट्स अनयूजुअल कंप्लेंट्स में वो सब कंप्लेंट्स आएंगी जो कि होटल के अभी हाथ में नहीं है द फर्स्ट थ्री कंप्लेंट्स मैकेनिकल सर्विस रिलेटेड एंड एटीट्यूडनल आर इन द हैंड्स ऑफ द होटल सो इफ देयर इज अ मैलफंक्शनिंग ऑफ इक्विपमेंट और देयर इज An improper service provided to the guest or the staff is not behaving properly, that can be sorted out by the hotel management. Immediate action may be taken and the problem may be sorted out. So we say that these complaints are in the hands of the management. However, in case of unusual complaints, these complaints are not in the hands of the management at the moment. So for example, a guest saying that I don't like the size of the room. आपके रूम का साइज अच्छा नहीं है या वास्तु के हिसाब से आपके रूम में वार्डरोब यहाँ नहीं वहां होना चाहिए था ठीक है सो दीज कंप्लेंट्स विल बी कंसीडर्ड एज अनयूजुअल ऐसे अनयूजुअल नहीं है अगर गेस्ट साइज के लिए कंप्लेन कर रहा है या गेस्ट बोल रहा है आपके होटल में गोल्फ फैसिलिटी क्यों नहीं है या आपके होटल में स्विमिंग पूल क्यों नहीं है शिवपाक के होटल्स में कईयों में स्विमिंग पूल नहीं होते सो गेस्ट में कंप्लेन अबाउट इट वी पुट ऑल दीज कंप्लेंट्स इन अंडर अनयूजुअल बट एक्चुअली अनयूजुअल नहीं है अनयूजुअल क्यों बोलते हैं हम अनयूजुअल बोल रहे हैं क्योंकि अभी एट प्रेजेंट होटल विल नॉट बी एबल टू डू एनीथिंग अबाउट इट अभी तो स्विमिंग पूल नहीं बन सकता रूम का साइज बड़ा नहीं हो सकता वास्तु के हिसाब से वार्डरोब चेंज नहीं हो सकता यहाँ से उखाड़ के वहां नहीं लगा सकते तो अभी कुछ नहीं हो सकता इसीलिए अनयूजुअल है ठीक है बट इन केस ऑफ दीज कंप्लेंट्स इट कैन बी नोटेड डाउन एक कंप्लेंट रजिस्टर जरूर होता है सजेशन रजिस्टर होता है होटल के पास It can be noted down so that when the hotel comes up for the expansion of the hotel, whenever hotel mein decoration interiors change hote rehte hain ya new building ban rahi hai, wahan pe in sab complaints ko entertain kiya ja sakta hai future mein, but not at the moment. It also includes complaints about the weather. ठीक है, बारिश रोज बारिश हो रही है, मैं घूमने नहीं जा पा रहा हूँ, कितनी ठंड है यहाँ पर. All these are considered to be unusual complaints. ठीक है अब इसमें तो कुछ नहीं कर सकते रूम के साइज वगैरह को तो चलो लिख सकते, वी कैन नोट इट डाउन एंड द मैनेजमेंट कैन कंसिडर ऑल दीज पॉइंट्स इफ वैलिड इन द नियर फ्यूचर एट द टाइम ऑफ एक्सपेंशन. बट इन केस द गेस्ट इज कंप्लेनिंग अबाउट बैड वेदर और अबाउट कोल्ड वेदर, देन ऑल ही इज एक्सपेक्टिंग इवन व्हेन ही इज मेकिंग अ कंप्लेंट, ऑल हिज एक्सपेक्टेशंस आर इज टू जस्ट यू नो अग्री विद द गेस्ट. हाँ सर, मौसम बहुत खराब है, हम भी परेशान हो गए हैं, बहुत दिनों से बारिश हो रही है. ठीक है, तो ये अनयूजुअल कंप्लेंट्स में इसीलिए अनयूजुअल है बिकॉज द मैनेजमेंट कैन नॉट हैंडल इट एट द मोमेंट. सो आइदर नोटिंग इट डाउन फॉर फ्यूचर रेफरेंस और जस्ट अग्रीइंग विद द गेस्ट. हाँ सर ऐसा हो गया, गलत है. सो इसीलिए हम इसे बोलते हैं अनयूजुअल कंप्लेंट. सो आई होप दीज टाइप्स ऑफ कंप्लेंट्स आर क्लियर. एंड अबाउट द गाइडलाइंस फॉर डीलिंग विद गेस्ट कंप्लेंट्स, ये सब हम कर चुके हैं, ये पूरा वीडियो है, इसमें बहुत सारे पॉइंट्स हैं, आप प्लीज देख लीजिए. ये चैप्टर खत्म हो गया है. ठीक है, दिस ड्यूरिंग द स्टे एक्टिविटीज चैप्टर इज ओवर. इफ देयर इज एनी डाउट यू मे प्लीज व्हाट्सएप एंड वी कैन टेक इट इन आवर नेक्स्ट क्लास. बिकॉज नेक्स्ट क्लास में अगर आपकी कंप्लेन अगर आपके डाउट्स नहीं है तो हम अगला चैप्टर शुरू कर देंगे. और अगर आपके डाउट्स हैं प्लीज मैसेज मी बाय टुडे इवनिंग सो दैट इफ some topic needs more explanation I can prepare accordingly. otherwise hum next class mein shuru karenge interdepartmental coordination. theek hai, so my class is over for the day and I hope that things were clear. I'm not able to hear you. there's a lot of problems, no clarity. Okay, please repeat attitudinal complaint. All right, I've got one question. Please repeat attitudinal complaint. Attitudinal complaint is a very common complaint in our institute. ठीक है, हम हमेशा बात करते रहते हैं एज फैकल्टीज, हम बोलते रहते हैं अरे ये लड़के में तो बड़ा एटीट्यूड है, ये तो बड़ा रूड है. वैष्णव मोहन परिकर इज विजिबल ऑन माई स्क्रीन. वी हैड अ इंसिडेंट इन आवर क्लास वेयर वैष्णव मोहन परिकर वाज़न्ट लिसनिंग when I was teaching. So there was this argument that was taking place between both of us and it was regarding why is he not paying attention. So he told me that ma'am, I don't want to work in hotels. So that is an example, current example of attitudinal complaint, because I had a complaint about his attitude of not being attentive in the class. All right, similarly in hotels, the guest may say that you know the your staff is so ill mannered, they don't even wish me. I was smiling at them, they don't even smiled back at me. Or the guest may say that the way whatever served to me, that was very rude. He came up with the plates and he just put it on the table with a bang. Aaya aur ekdam dhaad karke plate rakh diya mere table pe. या आया और मुझे कुछ पूछा ही नहीं, सीधे पानी लेकर आया, सर्व करने लगा. He didn't even ask me what kind of preference do I have for water. Will I have lukewarm water or I have normal water? ठीक है, so ये सब attitude वाला problem है. जैसे शशांक करीब के बाल कंघी नहीं है, शेव नहीं किया है, मुझे दिखाई दे रहा है. तो अब ये मैं जो बोल रही हूँ ये मैं कौन सी कंप्लेन कर रही हूँ, मैं कर रही हूँ attitudinal complaint. ओके, ज्यादातर टीचर्स हम जो करते रहते हैं ना पूरे टाइम तुम लोगों को, वो जो कंप्लेंट होती है वो होती है एटीट्यूडनल कंप्लेंट. पढ़ाई नहीं करते हो तो क्या है, दीज आर ऑल एटीट्यूडनल कंप्लेंट. वेरी गुड शशांक, आई होप टू सी यू लाइक दिस ऑन वेंसडे ऑल्सो. ठीक है, सो आई होप थिंग्स आर क्लियर. अगर अभी भी अब टाइम हो गया है सो वी हैव टू लॉग आउट, बट अगर अभी भी कोई प्रॉब्लम होगा तो आप प्लीज व्हाट्सएप कर देना. विल टेक अप इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑलराइट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद अ न्यू टॉपिक. ठीक है, सो नेक्स्ट सेशन वुड बी अबाउट इंटर डिपार्टमेंटल कोऑर्डिनेशन. पढ़ के आना. ठीक है, इंटर डिपार्टमेंटल कोऑर्डिनेशन. ठीक है, चलो टाटा बाय बाय, सी यू, टेक केयर एंड बी हैप्पी एंड अटेंड ऑल द क्लासेस. थैंक यू
मैम.
थैंक यू मैम.
थैंक यू.
थैंक यू मैम.
अपना थैंक यू मैम.
थैंक यू मैम.
थैंक यू मैम.
Okay.